Well, chaos has unfolded at Wimbledon with play halting not once but twice due to climate protesters storming the court and throwing confetti during matches. Nine Sports presenter Tony Jones was courtside when the chaos ensued. He joins us live now. TJ, thanks so much for your time. You were right there. In fact, you filmed that footage. Pretty good footage, by the way. How did this all unfold?
Well, it was quite bizarre because it happened in the first match on court 18 and there were two protesters there that did exactly the same thing, and you would have thought that after that security would have been beefed up to the extent that they would have sort of thwarted any repeat performance. But this is the repeat performance here. Now, how this bloke got away with it is quite simple when you look at it, because they've simply gone to the gift shop, they've bought a jigsaw puzzle, which is in a box, put it in the knapsack, cut up some confetti. So for all intents and purposes, once the security guards looked at the knapsack and saw there was a souvenir jigsaw puzzle in there, well, no alarm bells would be ringing. But it was during the first set tiebreaker, when Daria Saville was leading 4-2, that this clown jumped the fence and then ran on there, opened up the box of the jigsaw and threw everything over the court. Now, there were more farcical scenes because it was Daria Saville who had to help the ball kids actually clean up the mess on court before the heavy artillery came in, that being the big blowers that sort of cleared the court. So the delay was unbelievable, and the crowd, having endured it in the first match on court 18, were simply fed up when it happened again.
Well, I mean, it's just ridiculous. It's actually laughable when you watch it. He's got a puzzle, he's got confetti, he's on the court. And as you said, the fact that one of the players is having to help clear it, it's just absurd. I mean, the crowds mustn't have been happy either. And it went on to affect Daria's game.
It did. Sarah, you're not going to believe this. So she had to put up with a rain delay first, which she was leading 6-5 at the time. So that broke her momentum. She came back the next day. She was leading 4-2 in that tiebreaker before that protest happened. And then once play started again, she had to put up with these three idiots that were on the fence that, brace yourself, every time she served, they made a flatulence noise, which put her off her game. And as a result of that, she went to the umpire during the break after the first set and complained. And then she said, how do I actually put this in words, but they are making noises like breaking wind every time I go to serve. And it was definitely putting her off her game. And after that, she just simply didn't recover.
Gee, that's a pain for a player to put up with. And especially, do we reckon there's a bit of residual anger there from the Poms?
Well, no, I think it's just stupidity. It really is. I mean, you can't legislate against it. Security guards can't control it in many respects. It's just sheer stupidity. But how do you actually compel that or repel that?
All right. Well, we know you were courtside, TJ, so as long as it wasn't you making those farting noises, right? Just to clarify.
Whoa. No. Let's just put that on the record,
Sarah.
Right now. I mean, I know there's been... I just...
TJ!
Seriously.
That's disgusting, TJ.
Seriously.
It makes us laugh, TJ. It's funny.
You know what? He does love his curries in London.
Oh, my God. Are you still on... Are we still on air?
We're still on air, TJ.
Are we still on air?
Yes. Live national television. Jeez. We're talking about farts.
Farts are funny. Come on.
Oh, my God. Stop saying that word. Stop saying that word.
Farts.
Jeez, Sarah.
Kids,
Sarah, what's
funny.
He done to you? Get back to 60 Minutes,
no, exactly.
I know.
I've eroded all of her
credibility. Save me, TJ. Come and save me, please.
She doesn't take much encouragement.